Now we're going to head out to meteorologist Mallory Brooke. She is reporting to us live from Rumford this morning, where you said the roads are very icy, and also you've got the flood warning there for the Androscoggin, Mallory.
Yeah, a little bit of everything this morning. Typical April in New England. We do have ice-covered roadways, fresh coating of snow, still getting some flurries coming down as we are here at the banks of the Androscoggin River in Rumford. It is definitely a raging river behind me. We are in a minor flood stage with the level at 16.32 feet as of 5:45 this morning, and flood stage is 15 feet, anticipated to crest within the next hour or so, just below 17 feet, which is a moderate flood stage. Getting a lot of folks from around town taking pictures this morning, and also getting word that there are portions of Route 2, Route 5, Route 26, and 232 that are underwater. There are portions of these roads that are underwater, and we can't stress enough to make sure you do not go through these flooded roadways. Find a different way to your destination. We are keeping you updated on flood warnings across the area this morning. News 8's Norm Karkos is live from Water Street in Augusta to let us know how folks are handling the flooding in the Capital District.
On Front Street, just adjacent to Water Street, along the banks of the many Kennebec River, where it's at crest stage right now. As you can see, what you're looking at right now, that the waters have started to crest over along the banks here, and that's going to impact some businesses close to noon. The problem is that you got some barriers over there, some walls, but that's not going to do much good in just a couple of hours. So that's where things are right now as the waters continue to rise. Now, people here in Augusta began preparing as the water started to rise yesterday. Business owners were out boarding up their property and filling up sandbags. River expected a crest later today, close to above 20 feet. That's 8 feet above flood level. That means some people will likely have to pump water out of their basements. That'll be a far cry from what people actually saw here in 1987 when flooding caused $100 million in damage and left thousands homeless. The annual rising of the water here along the banks of the Kennebec has become quite a spectacle as people gather to watch the raging waters. We met one man who says storm watching is now a common pastime here with him.
So this is a tradition for us every year. Usually we end up going down to Hollowell, Gardner, following the Kennebec River.
And again, you're looking at live pictures from the banks of the Kennebec River where the water is cresting over. What you're looking at is usually a parking spot here on any given day, with the exception of this time of the year. But the businesses will be obviously keeping a very close eye on the water as they continue to rise and reach some businesses here on Water Street by noon today. So that's the situation here along the banks of the Kennebec River in Waterfront Park at Augusta. I'm Norm Karkos, News 8 WMTW.